This tutorial covers multiple ways to color digital art faster. These coloring methods work for any art style that has blank areas intended to be filled with color. Before I get into fast coloring tricks, if your line art has gaps, there are two ways to make it so selection and bucket tools work. One is to duplicate your line art and then close gaps yourself. Use this new temporary layer to make your selections for coloring. When finished, hide or discard the altered line art. Option two is to adjust your selection tool's sensitivity to gaps. Not every art program can do this, but some can. Also, if your line art is a bunch of different layers, duplicate all that and flatten it into one master copy. Use the master copy to make selections, and you can get rid of it when you're done. Okay, on to coloring. Paint and erase. Instead of slow and careful coloring along the edge to avoid mistakes, be fast and free with your strokes. When finished, erase everything outside the line. This method is great if you're the type of person who does many colors on one layer. Be messy and don't clean up until the end. Bucket tool. Duplicate the line art. Bucket fill colors into the bottom copy. The downsides to this method are the fill not extending to the line, sometimes solvable by bucket clicking the area more than once, and that having a second copy of the line art affects its edges. This downside is more obvious if you have semi-transparent parts in your line art. Magic wand. Hold shift and click all the selections you want to fill with the same color. Then expand the selection by two or more pixels. This ensures color is going to reach all the way to the line. Bucket fill the selection on a layer under the line art. You might have to look up how to expand selections in your art program. The ability to modify or transform selections is usually hidden in a submenu or a keyboard shortcut. Inverted selection. With the magic wand, click outside the line art. Hold shift and click any inner areas that are not supposed to be colored. Then invert the selection. Shrink the selection by two or more pixels. Bucket fill on a layer under the line art. It's important to shrink the selection or color will seep outside the edges. Clipping mask. Once you've used any method to make a base layer of color, use the base layer as a clipping mask for new color layers. That way, when you draw on them, the colors won't go outside the lines. Masking. If you don't have clipping masks, you might have regular masks as a menu option. Turn your base layer into a mask based on transparency or alpha channel. Apply the mask to color layers as needed. Only thing to be careful with here is that if you alter the shape of your base layer later, you'll have to update all of your masks with the new shape. The last and fastest coloring method I know of is something called actions. Photoshop and Clip Studio Paint both have these. There are probably some other higher-end professional programs that have them. You can program your favorite coloring method to work with one click. I use Magic Wand for coloring flats, so what I've done is select something and then press record in the action pane to create one of these pre-made scripts. From there, I expand the selection, fill the selection, and deselect. Stop recording the action. And now, when I want to color, I select my areas, pick the layer I want to color on, and then all I have to do is click Custom Action Color. Done. All that will be left to do is a few manual touch-ups in really sharp corners. Hope these tips inspired some ideas on how to improve your coloring process. This video is part of a tutorial series you can find below.